Hello guys, it's Rishabh Mavani from ITB second year. Today I am going to explain you about variadic functions in C. What is a variadic function? A variadic function is a function which can accept a variable number of arguments. To use this function, you have to include stdarg.h as one of the header files. Why do we need a variadic function? Okay, let's talk about ordinary C function. We know ordinary C function can take a fixed number of arguments. For example, if I define a function int func open parenthesis int comma character asterisk, for this function you must call two arguments, which is a number and a character pointer. This is one of the drawback of ordinary C function, as it can take fixed number of arguments. In some cases the function can handle any number of values. Let us take a very good example, malloc. Malloc is a function that is used to allocate memory to one-dimensional array, two-dimensional array, or any multi-dimensional array, which can hold a specific set of values. Without facilities for variable arguments, you have to define a separate function for each possible array size. Now, the library function printf is an example of another class of function where variable arguments are used. This function can print all kind of data types, which can be a number or a string or a character or anything. These are the good reasons to define a variadic function which can handle as many arguments as a user want to pass. How variadic function is defined? To define the function as variadic, we have to use ellipsis. Ellipsis is variable arguments in the argument list. We can access these ellipses by using special macros present in header file called stdarg.h. Then declare the function as variadic using a prototype with ellipsis to call it. Then call the function by writing fixed argument and then followed by additional variable arguments, that is ellipsis. Now see how to access them and declare them. Let us follow the steps for accessing and declaring a variadic function. First, you have to initialize an argument pointer variable of type va_list. Then you have to use va_start, which will help you to initialize points to the first optional argument. And then you have to access the optional arguments by successful calls to va_arg. The first call to va_arg will give you the first optional argument, and similarly the next call gives you the second, and it continues. And then you can stop at any time if you wish to ignore any remaining optional arguments. Yes, we can access fewer arguments than were supplied in the call, but you will get garbage values if you try to access too many arguments. Then you indicate that you have finished by using argument pointer variable by calling va_end. Let us see an example of variadic function as a program. In this program, in first line, I have included a header file called stdarg.h. Now let us go to our user defined function int add_em_up open parenthesis int count comma ellipsis. Now I have declared ap as a va_list type, and then I have used va_start open parenthesis ap comma count. After initializing sum equal to 0, I have included sum in a loop and I did the following operation: sum plus or equal to va_arg open parenthesis ap comma int. This will keep on repeating to the next argument value, and this will add the next argument value to the sum. And when you are finished, we have to give va underscore end as I gave in line 28. And then we are returning the value of sum to the function. And then in the main function, first call is given in line number 8 to add underscore em underscore up. By doing this, now int count will take value as 3 and the ellipsis will take other optional argument as 5, 5 and 6. So by following this operation, this will return a value called 16. Another call to add underscore em underscore up is given in line number 11 in printf statement. Here count will take the value as 10 as there are 10 optional arguments, and then ellipsis will take 10 optional arguments, that is 1, 2, 3 and so on up to 10. And after doing the operation, it will return the value as 55 in the main function. And this is how this program works. And this is a very good example of variadic function in C. Okay friends, that is all about variadic functions. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. It's Rishabh Mavani, second year ITB.